Hi, I'm Seth Boustead. I'm the Executive Director of Access Contemporary Music, and I'm also the founder and producer of the Sound of Silent Film Festival. Welcome to night two of our 15th annual Sound of Silent Film Festival. I'm coming to you tonight from the Davis Theater, the magnificently restored Davis Theater in Chicago, Illinois, where 3 months ago, almost exactly to the day, we would have presented the 15th annual Sound of Silent Film Festival, but all in one night. We were gonna do two completely different programs in one night. We were gonna do a whiskey tasting with our local distillery, Koval, in between those two showings. We had a Q&A lined up with composers and filmmakers who were traveling to Chicago for the festival. It was gonna be a really big production. Of course, we know what happened in March. But we have found a light side to presenting the festival virtually, which is really great. One is that many of you watching right now are not in Chicago. So for the first year, we're actually able to share this work, this wonderful work, these films and music with people outside of Chicago. So that's fantastic. And I think the second one is, I was thinking about this today, musicians every year are always kind of saying, we don't get to watch the films, we want to watch the films. Well, they're all on the comfort of their couches right now watching the films. So that's a nice thing about presenting this festival virtually as well. All of the films that you're seeing tonight have been submitted to us especially for the Sound of Silent Film Festival. They come from all over the world. They include comedies, dramas, documentaries. This year, for the first time, we have a dance film in What If, which is really, really amazing. And we then, with the help of a film review panel, we narrowed that down to 14 new films, and we chose two audience favorites from the past, including the film we just saw, Marquee, by Brian Zahm. Then we choose the composers, we commission the composers to write new music for the pieces. This year the process of matching composer to films was actually pretty non-contentious, no fights this year, which was really, really nice. And the composers get busy and then we put it all together. We have two categories, one is a truly silent film and the other is a film that has no dialogue in it, minimal sound effects so that it'll work in silence. And then if there is a sound effect that's germane to the plot or to your understanding of the film, that's a challenge for the composer. They have to recreate that effect acoustically. We have done everything we can to present this festival to you at the highest possible quality level, even though it's virtual this year. We have put an enormous amount of time, energy, and money into giving you the best possible festival. We are doing a free presentation tonight, but we're asking for a $20 suggested donation per household. So if you like what you're seeing, if you like what you hear, and you want to support us, please do text to donate or donate through our website. Thanks so much, and enjoy the show.
Hi, I'm David Wetzel. I'm the technical director for Access Contemporary Music. What goes into a production like this? Well, we have 16 films, all from different filmmakers, work from different composers, and so a variety of music and technical requirements. The main thing that I do for Sound of Silent Film Festival usually is make click tracks and put them together with the films so that we can coordinate the music with the picture when we show it live in the theater. This year, of course, is different because we're recording everything, so we have microphones on every single instrument, and we're doing a full recording session in over 2 days. Then we'll be editing and mixing and getting that ready for the final viewing. One of the challenges, of course, is when we're recording with click tracks in everybody's ears, there's the issue of making sure that we don't hear a click track coming through, you know, bleeding into the microphones. I have microphones very close up on everybody, and they hear everything. And so, you know, we've spent a lot of time just troubleshooting and finding all of those little extra noises. Sometimes something happens, like somebody will trip over something or drop something in the middle of a take, and we'll have to go back and re-record parts of it. Mostly, it's been a very straightforward production, though. It's actually gone very well. I'm fortunate to be working with such incredibly gifted and professional musicians, and it's been a joy.
Thank you. Thank you.